I would like to introduce Hartmut Tintrup. Again, he is the Chief Business Officer at Sevic, and he is going to be presenting the CAPCO Cell Expression System, the new standard in authentic human glycolization. Hartmut.
Thank you very much for this introduction, and thanks, of course, for your interest, everybody, in our technology. And yeah, we are here to actually launch a new part of our portfolio, technology portfolio, which is called the CAPGO system that I would like to present here actually. And yeah, what we have is actually human suspension cell line that is derived from amniocytes. And if you look at the current platforms that are out there to produce biotherapeutics, you can see that with the increase in complexity of these molecules that you can see here on the x-axis, you need to have the appropriate expression system. So if you look at peptides, lower molecular substances, E. coli and yeast, of course, are very capable of doing that. The CHO cells derived from hamster are actually the platform that are suited for antibodies. And if it comes then to human viruses and complex glycoproteins, actually you need different systems. And our CUP cells, they are now positioned to produce the complex glycoproteins and plasma proteins that are otherwise difficult to produce in CHO cells. And with our new portfolio of CAPGO cells and CAPGO cell lines that I'm going to elaborate on, actually, we are now capable to address these molecules very efficiently. So the CAPGO system is a portfolio of individual glyco-optimized CAPGO cell lines for N and O glycolated plasma proteins, complex glycoproteins, and antibodies. Our cells work very well for antibodies, but the target molecules that we really are specialize in are the complexity glycosylated molecules like coagulation factors, plasma protein cytokines. And these individual glyco-optimized cell lines now allow tailor-made glycosylation patterns, so you can targetedly influence the glycosylation pattern of your molecule. You get high protein titers. I can show you now with the example molecules that are going to follow, we can improves the pharmacokinetic properties of these molecules, and this in return then leads in a reduction in production costs actually. So how are we organized in Cologne? We have a CAP Technology Center, Germany, Cologne, where we do our customer support, where we have our R&D team, where we do the technology development, the cell line and process development. So we offer our cell line development services there. We do process development and the optimization of culture parameters. The licensing business, we license out our technology, is centered there. And we also have headquartered in Cologne the CMO activities. We have formed a strategic joint venture with in Lisbon with GenEBED actually. And they have produced successfully in the past for us cGMP material based on our CAP cells. And that is actually the second location where we offer the cGMP production part, and we can provide up to phase two material via that collaboration. And if you look now at the conventional systems that are out there, they are very often optimized for antibody production. So if you look at the CHO cells, I mean, it's a success story. Everybody knows that. You can produce antibodies very efficiently in those cells. But if it comes then to the more complex proteins, you very often see low yields for these plasma proteins, for example, coagulation factors and other difficult to produce molecules. And the post-translational modifications provided can also be missing, they can be incorrect. If these are Chinese hamster cells, they can be non-human, or they are non-human and can be immunogenic actually to the patients. And there are already some examples, although they are rare, but they are out there. For example, factor 9 produced in CHO cells, you might know that actually that led to immune responses to the host cell proteins of Chinese hamster proteins. That's why we are convinced that the human cell as a production host for biopharmaceuticals is the superior one. And these CAPGO cells that we have developed, actually, they are ready to take this challenge. They allow the high titer production of plasma proteins. I mentioned already you can tailor your glycosylation patterns. You don't have immunogenic structures because they are authentically human. And you will also see later on that we have a homogeneous product quality, which in return can reduce your downstream costs. And these are pure suspension cells. They grow in single cell suspension. They are fully scalable to all bioreactors actually that are out there. We have a chemically defined serum-free media also designed for these cell lines, ready for cGMP production. So with terms to titles, if we look at difficult to produce proteins, it is not every time, but it can be up to tenfold higher if you look at the production rates in our cells, if you compare them to other mammalian cells like CHO cells. We also have a very high degree of viability in our cells. The cells are very robust. And due to that high viability, which is on a standard base higher than in the high 90%, we also do not see protein degradation. So usually the proteins that come out of our cells are very intact. And also observed and published actually by companies who have worked with our cells is also a low degree of product aggregation that has been observed. So let's come now to the tailor-made glycosylation aspect of our CAP-GO cells. So I mentioned already we have a portfolio of individual CAP cell lines that are individually glyco-optimized to address individual glycosylation patterns. So if you look at a complex molecule, if it's purified from human plasma, you have an entire mixture of different glycan structures that are on, basically present on the surface of these molecules. So, for example, you can have different antennary structure, diantennary structures, triantennary structures. You can have structures that are fully sialylated, that are not sialylated at all. And what we can do now with our individual cell lines, you can pick the isoform that you are interested in, and then you can enrich for this isoform that is depicted here on the right, actually. So by choosing the right CAP-GO cell line, actually, you can then targetedly produce only the isoform that you are interested in. And that is true for N-linked glycans, O-linked glycans, and others. And that in return actually allows you to get a very pure product, which means you don't have to spend so much purification efforts on your molecule. And it's also a reduction of time and cost then in the end. I mentioned already the cells are fully scalable. These are suspension cells. They grow in serum-free conditions. We have developed our own chemically defined media, also available at GMP quality, scalable to all bioreactor formats. The cells grow on a standard base to very high cell densities, which are routinely higher than 1 times 5 to 10 to the 7 cells. And also karyotype-wise, even after they haven't been made transgenic, they are very stable for at least more than 100 passages. They have a very, very superior regulatory documentation, these cells. We have a fully documented cell line history. I mentioned already they are derived from primary human amniocytes. Everything that was in touch actually with these cells when the cell lines were established has been fully documented. We have approached the regulatory authorities both in Europe and the USA. In Europe, actually, we got a very positive review by the Paul Ehrlich Institute, which is, so to say, the long arm of the EMA, of the German Regulatory Authority. And we are in the process of scheduling the meetings with the FDA to actually deposit a so-called cell substrate biological master file that could be then referenced by customers later on if they go through the regulatory process with their own molecules coming out of our cells. So we have chosen a couple of molecules to convince you that these cells actually can have a benefit if you produce biotherapeutics. Not all, but the majority of these are listed here. For example, C1 inhibitor, alkaline phosphatase, several blood coagulation factors, human alpha-1 antitrypsin. The cells also work for antibodies, IgG1s, and so on. But I just would like to pick two of them here that I would show you as an example. One of them is actually the human C1 esterase inhibitor. That's an inherited human disease, which leads to angioedema. And that is currently being treated by plasma-purified medications, namely Berinert and Cinryze. And you can see that these are significant markets, actually, that are out there. And these are serum-purified molecules. And it would be desirable to have a recombinant version available. That means you can have much more control of the production process and you don't have to rely on plasma as the source for this material. Another example is the human alkaline phosphatase that is in various clinical trials at the moment. Also a very interesting molecule in a variety of inflammatory indications. And that is actually also a molecule where we can show now superior pharmacokinetics that I will show you in a minute. So let's just first focus on the recombinant human C1 inhibitor. I don't have to go through the details now of this signaling cascade. Take-home message here is if this molecule is defect, actually, you have in the end an uncontrolled release of bradykinin, and that leads then actually to a damage in blood vessels and in the upper airways. And these patients actually have reoccurring attacks of edema in the face, abdomen, and that happens 5 to 12 times a year. And if that actually is life-threatening, if it appears in the throat, because then these patients can actually suffocate. Anyways, so that's an interesting indication, and the idea was now to develop a recombinant version. And here you can see now the pharmacokinetics of the recombinant C1 inhibitor if it comes out of our cells. And on the left, on these kinetics, you can actually see that the C1 inhibitor, if it comes out of our CAPGO cells, namely the CAPGO2 cell line, we can match the pharmacokinetics of Berinert, which is the plasma-purified version. And that is actually now the first time that somebody could show that a recombinant version matches the pharmacokinetics of serum-purified material. You can see that actually also in the middle, in these graphs, that in our CAPGO2 cells, that the C1 inhibitor matches the pharmacokinetics of Berinert. And that's actually not the case of the historically first material that we have produced, which was made in CAP wild-type cells that were genetically not modified. There you can see that the pharmacokinetics are actually inferior to the to Berinert. But also interesting take-home message here is we have now two versions of the recombinant C1 inhibitor, one with an increased plasma half-life and one with a short plasma half-life, and which is also valuable because there are acute and chronic indications, and these molecules actually would fit both into these directions. On the right, you can see that the specific activities actually of these CAPGO2 rederived C1 inhibitor matches the specific activity also of Berinert. That means we do not have here a decreased specific activity. And yields are actually up to 0.5 gram a liter, and that is already, for such a heavily glycosylated molecule, a yield with limited process optimization that is viable enough to go into large-scale pharmaceutical production. These are just some more analyses that have been performed on this molecule. On the left, you see an isoelectric focusing. You can then separate actually molecules according to their acidic character, and this is actually correlating with the sialic acid content of the molecules, and you can see in this blot, in this isoelectric focusing, that our CAPGO2-derived material matches the migration pattern of Berinert, and that is not the case actually for the conventionally produced C1 inhibitor, which you can see on the left. Also in a lectin blot that's in the middle actually, that is also a method to detect the sialic acid content of these molecules. This is actually a blot that works in a way that the less signal you observe, the higher the sialic content is actually. It's a lectin blot. And you can see that with our CAPGO2 derived material on the right in this blot, we are matching very closely the patterns actually of the serum purified material from Berinert. And on the right also, this is now a proof of the homogeneity of the post-translational modifications. You can see that Berinert on the far right has a CoR1 glycan structure that is very prominent. And on the left, you can see that we could not match that with the CAPGO1 cells. That looks quite different from the serum-purified Berinert. But with our CAPGO2 cells now, you can see that we can exactly copy this prevalence of the CoR1 glycan structure that is present in Berinert. Also interesting to see, look at the gas chromatography or gas chromatograms. On the top you see the pattern of Berinert. You see in the middle then conventionally produced recombinant C1 inhibitor, and on the very bottom you see the CAPGO2 derived C1 inhibitor, and you can see just by eye that the CAPGO2 derived C1 inhibitor looks very, very similar to the Berinert on top actually, and looks quite different from the conventionally produced C1 inhibitor. So all in all, a convincing example of a serum-purified molecule that can be now replaced with a recombinant version. The other molecule, just as an example, is the alkaline phosphatase. I mentioned already, it's in various clinical programs at the moment. Indications that are being of interest, sepsis, colitis, arthritis, and so on. Various preclinical applications are at the moment of interest, diabetes, actually all interesting markets. And here you can see now again the molecule, if it is derived from our CAPGO technology. These are now the CAPGO1 and CAPGO3 cells. And on the right you can see the pharmacokinetics. That's again in a rat study. And you can see that we can increase the plasma half-life of alkaline phosphatase in rats by a factor of up to four to five, actually, when compared to the conventional, conventionally produced alkaline phosphatase. On the left, just again in isoelectric focusing, and again you can see that there's a difference in the migration pattern between the Kapgol-derived material and the conventional molecule, indicating indeed that we have here significant changes on the post-translational modifications that are in favor of getting these improved pharmacokinetics. Yeah, so what we offer actually in Cologne, you could give us your molecule and we would use and apply our CapGo technology to perform the cell line development for you. So this is the classical work packages that we can perform as a contract manufacturer. We do the process development, upstream processing, downstream processing, protein purification, and of course also manufacturing at the moment up to clinical phase two can we provide cGMP material with our technology. And of course, if such a cell line has been generated, we would definitely also make sure to guarantee a smooth tech transfer into whatever facility you would like to transfer then these cells. Yeah, cell line development, I don't have to focus, I think, in detail on this. This is a classical approach to do cell line development. Take home message here is within 2 to 4 months, actually, we can generate a fully characterized single cell clone that usually has then also a good performance in terms of yields and performance in bioreactors. And mentioned already, process development expertise is there. We know our cells very well. We can do all the optimization steps necessary. We have experience with quite a variety of different reactor formats, wave, shaker flask, and so on. And as mentioned, also downstream processing can be offered, including GMP production. And here, of course, also the classical GMP manufacturing steps that are required, GMP master cell banking, bulk production, also fill and finish, and support with any dossier filing with regulatory authorities. Worthwhile mentioning is that we are, well, we would think that we are ready to actually innovate now this field of complex protein production. We have already signed two deals that are going to be announced also soon in the field of coagulation factors with major pharma companies. And I think we are on track actually to accept variety of different challenging molecules. So other than that, I think I'm at the end of my